So now welcome to the stage, Dr. Nick Delgado, PhD. He's also a diplomat of the American Board of Anti-Aging Practitioners, author of 10 books, and he is a world strength training endurance champion. He set a world record for curl and press. For curl and press, he completed 560 pounds in 1 hour for a curl and press. That you might be able to curl and press me. In April 2011, he also set the world record for 1,038 reps with 50 pounds. And he led Team USA to number one victory in London 2007. He is also the formulator of natural anti-aging products and a complete plan offered by the Delgado Protocol. Welcome to the stage. Thank you, Doctor.
We're really in the business of helping people to look great, feel sexy, stay at their optimum body weight, have better sleep, better quality of life, increase energy, and better love life. I think that we share certain things in regards to challenges, with health challenges, particularly with our family. Those of us who are in the industry and training and motivating people to eat healthy and exercise and to be their very best, oftentimes it's within our own family that our biggest challenges are. And I think back for my father when he, about 15 years ago, had developed high blood pressure and diabetes, and his wife at the time really wasn't open to the possibility that he needed to change his diet and do a complete change around in his lifestyle. So the doctors had him on blood pressure medications, prostate medications, hypertensive medications, and I took him to a colleague of mine, Dr. John McDougall in Northern California. And he said the same thing to him. He said, medications are temporary use. You need to start following a whole foods diet, exercise, get into the right mind state. And over time, over a 15-year period, he suffered another stroke. And finally, his wife decided that I could intervene, which I did. And we measured his hormone levels. We completely changed his diet, got him eating whole foods smoothies every morning, and a great nutritional program and supplements, and optimized his hormone levels. We even did testosterone pellets for him. Within a few weeks, he was off all of his medications. His levels had normalized. And it was 15 years that he had been on those medications and struggled, and in most cases, he became incoherent on those very same medications, and due to some lifestyle factors and the challenge of Alzheimer's and the inability to communicate, to even recognize his youngest grandson, their little Roman, their age 5, and my brother next to him, and my son behind him, age 21. He came to life. He would laugh. He told jokes. His energy came back. Everything changed. And I only think back about what it would take to help people to snap out of their coma and help them to realize that even within their own family, we have to work very diligently to exert what we know to be correct. And oftentimes, medical doctors are great for emergencies. We all agree that in an accident, you know, what would we do without being able to be repaired and so forth? But what is it about hypothyroidism, hormone deficiency, testosterone deficiency, excesses in estrogen, imbalances in cortisol, Most of us are not trained thoroughly enough about what it takes to optimize our hormone levels. And when I was 23, there's a picture of me there where I weighed well over 200 pounds and over 25% body fat, and I had my first TIA, a transient ischemic attack, a small stroke. And it was that kind of awakening on blood pressure medications that I realized that the medications were not protecting me. I read a book called Live Longer Now by Nathan Pritikin. I followed that program, and within 6 months, I reduced about 50 pounds, and I met him at a conference in Pasadena. He invited me to come work with him at the Pritikin Longevity Center, what I would say was the kind of the forerunner to most of the quality anti-aging programs that are available today. The picture at the bottom was taken last month before the Arnold Classic, where I competed in the world's strongest strength endurance competitions, defeating the world's strongest men, lifting 35-pound dumbbells overhead more times than anyone in the competition. Also, with 45-pound dumbbells in each hand, a hammer curl press overhead, I exceeded all the competitors in that division as well. It was an open-age competition against all competitors, 30, 35, 40, and I'll be 60 this year. So competing against athletes, world-class athletes, Team USA, there's my son at the back of the room, and Brandon, my brother, and Big Tim Nash. This is me competing at the Arnold Classic with Dragan Radovich and some of the world-class athletes. I believe that fitness includes stimulation of lymphatics, include some kind of rebounding or trampoline work, increase your muscle strength and core. And I like interval training, but I believe you can go beyond that. I believe that there should be little or no rest between sets and repetitions. So you can do continuous lifts by drop setting, pyramiding, dropping the weight a little bit, and continuing the sets. Whatever the exercise is, continuous for at least 30 to 45 minutes, in which you can generate massive amounts of energy. That'll improve your cardio, your flexibility, and your core, and include some not just hyperbaric oxygen training. I use altitude, cyclic variations, and adaptive conditioning to stimulate at 20,000 feet altitudes, 1,000 feet drops per second. And in a 20-minute session, it stimulates your mitochondria to come alive, your rejuvenation, and your energy, and your recovery after workout. Because no matter how hard you work out, the key is to be able to recover and come back and train again in a serious manner that will allow you to progress throughout your training session. Cooling the body to a very low body temperature, core body temperature with the Avicen device there, where you put your hand in and it draws and sucks the pressure and it reduces your core body temperature. This has been shown by Stanford University to improve fitness output in people doing pull-ups from doing 100 pull-ups, where in sets they could do 600 pull-ups, a 600% improvement in less than 3 months. So we believe that there's several factors, and when you overheat like a car, it's very dangerous, and you can't even possibly take in enough fluid to offset overheating. So keep your gym facilities or your training conditions in very, very cool conditions. If you're perspiring profusely, that's a healthy thing in regards to removing toxins, but not a healthy thing in regards to losing too much fluids. Be very careful in that regard. In senior training, your hormones must be balanced, and your fitness levels must be at their best. And there's only 70 people in the entire world past 110 years of age. So we realize that there's some trigger point in terms of chromosome replication, in terms of hormone decline, and overall a decline in every symptom or system of the body. So what are we going to do? At the Arnold Classic, Arnold gave a very great presentation about what he's accomplished and how his drive started very early on, and his dream was always put forth before him to accomplish his goals, and he did not let anyone detract him from what he wanted to accomplish in life. Arnold, I'll be back. Of course, using hormone therapy, it's something that most of us need to recognize is critical, because as we age past 35, testosterone levels drop rather drastically, and ironically, estrogen levels increase equally as high. In fact, an estrogen level of 56 may not seem that high compared to a testosterone of 500. However, estrogen is over 100 times more has more affinity to the testosterone receptor sites than does the testosterone itself. So we have a problem in decline of bone density, drop in libido, sexual function, and fitness, and we can simply restore this through a series of understanding phytochemical and herbal interventions and hormonal bioidentical interventions. I had created a product in the year 2002 called Estroblock. And I noticed that as it balanced the hormones and cleared the harmful unmetabolized estrogens, and it restored the good form of estrogen in men as well, they had a decrease in gynecomastia, in breast tissue mass, as they age. They had a reduction in body fat level. And interesting enough, they had a dramatic clearing of their skin. Do you realize over 80% of people will suffer from acne at some time during their life? And there's probably, all told, over 10 million cases that present. And oftentimes, it's shocking to hear that the number one therapy used for young people, particularly females with acne, is birth control pills. And these are synthetic hormones that come from a horse, and they're synthesized that are chemically different, and they exert very harmful effects on the body. And here we're trying to clear up the skin by flooding the body with more estrogen, when in reality, it's estrogen dominance that's causing the problem. And the problem can be solved quite clearly, because as you take in significant amounts of dimethylmethane from raw cruciferous vegetables, indole-3-carbinol, and wasabi, which was the 2011 Nobel Prize winning herb for the discovery that it would bring people out of a coma in the situation where they were knocked unconscious. So it's interesting that a combination of certain phytochemicals detoxify, or that is, help to metabolize estrogen through its pathways and removing it out the urine successfully, and then allowing the good estrogen through apoptosis, the 2-hydroxyestrone, to be restored. Also in women, there should be a 3-to-1 ratio of estriol to estrone, and we rarely see that because of birth control pills, synthetic hormones, and or the fatty diet the average American consumes. So when we see this and fat reaches the gut, it converts into more estrogens, and so in both men and women, we have an estrogen-dominant society. When people started taking Estroblock, they noticed that it cleared up their acne. Worldwide, a phenomenon, bloggers were talking about how Estroblock cleared up their acne, and there was videos of it before and after within 2 to 3 months of completely clearing acne on their back, their face, their skin, and it was because their hormones had reached a natural hormonal balance. That product now is a worldwide phenomena and a number one seller for me, which is quite amazing because I originally developed it for greater concerns about cancer associated with unmetabolized estrogens, breast cancer, prostate cancer, which I still believe quite firmly that in the next 5 years, if you look up on a Google search, 2-methoxyestrone is one of the most potent natural agents that offsets and can fight not just breast and prostate cancer, which we used to think estrogen dominant cancers were related to that factor, but now we know most cancers are related to estrogen dominance. Pancreatic cancer, liver cancer, brain cancer, all of them have some direct or indirect relationship. And you realize pesticides tend to have a chemical that mimics estrogen. We know that xenoestrogens in the plastic bottles that you drank out of have a toxic chemical. We know that there are several factors that cause these problems. So hormonal imbalances are rampant in our society. And what about chronic fatigue and the incidence of arthritis? Or do you suffer from increased frequency of colds or flus? Because as you increase anabolic hormones, and oftentimes those are synthetic rather than bioidentical and natural, we then tend to suppress the adrenal system. We must support adrenal levels with a natural cortisol byproduct from cortisol extracts. Michael Jackson would suffer from fatigue, and to stay awake to do his performances at night, he would drink massive amounts of Coca-Cola or Pepsi, whichever he was endorsing at the time. And in that regard, it would keep him up all night after the rehearsal. So his doctor, he would beg to give him propofol, a sedative through IV, and on the fatal night that he died, it was the 5th injection that killed him. And he died of heart failure. On autopsy, his heart was completely clean. He was nearly vegetarian, so he had no plaques in his arteries, but his heart failed due to an overdose of a drug to offset caffeine. We are a caffeine-dependent society because we don't understand how to drive natural energy without drug stimulants such as caffeine. Caffeine is right up to cocaine as a top seller in the world. So we can reverse fatigue. We know that sleep is absolutely essential, and sleep is stimulated by the neurotransmitters associated with nitric oxide. There are at least four plant foods amongst many that I could tell you about, but kale, beet, Swiss chard, and arugula will stimulate the nitric oxide cycles along with a product I created called Stay Young. And what it does is it helps you go into the deepest phases of sleep. So you sleep like a baby. I have five children, ages 5 to 35. So when I sleep with my little 5-year-old, I sleep as well as he does because I have learned how to optimize my nitric oxide levels, something I can teach every one of you. At the back of the booth, I have a little simple test. You put a little saliva on the strip, and we can measure your nitric oxide levels within 4 seconds, the count of four, and tell you if you are depleted, which most are. Even if you're in fitness, I can guarantee you, unless you know and you're consuming the right combinations, the right amount of certain juices and so forth, you're not going to have optimum nitric oxide levels. And it only takes about 5 days to really reach optimum levels. Adrenal DMG, dimethylglycine, helps the liver to go through several biochemical reactions, and it will improve your energy levels at a natural level. We know nitrogenous base that gorillas and bulls can draw massive amounts of nitrogen from plant-based foods. And so we've discovered there are certain ways to, again, improve the Krebs cycle, the ATP cycle, and generating natural energy. This is one of the reasons why I can still compete against world strength endurance competition athletes half my age and defeat them every time. 2 billion people in the world are iodine deficient. And Dr. Terry Hertog, my colleague, had trained his father before him, also an endocrinologist, had discovered that cold hands and feet. And by the way, shake hands with the person next to you. Tell me who has the coldest hands. Please take a moment, shake hands. Everyone shake hands, reach over, grab someone behind you, in front of you, and who has the coldest hands? Now, some of you know you have cold hands, and you chronically walk around with cold hands and cold feet. Doesn't mean you probably have warm heart, I get it. But the reality is, listen to me closely. If you go to your doctor with a temperature, a fever of 101 degrees, he says you're sick and sends you home. But if you come in, instead of with 98.6, say 96.4, and your temperature's below normal, you are sick. Your biochemistry is not right, and you're suffering certain symptoms of premature aging and risking cancer of the breast and other things that are more susceptible and more virulent if you have low thyroid levels. Tendency to gain weight, low energy, low sex drive, poor mental clarity, brittle nails, aging of skin and hair. We can simply replace this, and knowing that Fukushima is spewing out massive amounts of radioactive particles here into the San Diego coast and into our fish and into our food supply, so you must take at least 12 to 30 milligrams of iodine every day to protect the thyroid and to preserve thyroid function. Myxedema in this patient here at the top, within about 6 months of treatment of T3, T4, which is not natural whole thyroid complex, and iodine, had restored his function and even took years off his look in terms of his bloating and so forth. Now, it's been a new phenomena to learn about bioidentical hormones, and yet the shocking thing is the Chinese knew about bioidentical hormones 3,000 years ago. They actually would take the urine from young females or the urine from young males aged 15 to 22, and they would dry the urine and take that concentrate into a cream and rub it into the older senior females or older males of that society. And over 100 hormones were measured, including growth hormone, DHEA, testosterone, to absorb into their skin and truly reverse aging. They knew about bioidentical hormones 3,000 years ago. And yet we've perverted it. We've gone ahead and used horse urine, not even from the same species, and we then perpetuate that Premarin and progestins are safe, and yet they have many serious side effects. So improving the body through bioidentical hormone replacement and your love life, of course, hormones will improve significantly in regards to erectile function and blood flow to the male or female genitalia. But nitric oxide is so important in circulation, in fitness and exercise, not just sleep, but in endurance and strength. So beetroots, greens, radish, kale, Swiss chard, and a product I created, as I mentioned, Stay Young, has these tablets that release massive amounts of nitric oxide. And all of us need to eat at least about 20 servings of fruits and vegetables a day. And you say 5 servings or 10. That's ridiculous. You can't possibly get the 360,000 different phytochemicals and enzymes your body needs and the fiber you need unless you consume massive amounts like primitive societies did when they foraged for food. We now eat small portions, thinking we're going to stay slim, of fatty contents of meat and cheese and eggs, and then we suffer the consequences. As you can see, artichokes, asparagus are rich in protein, low in fat, rich in complex carbohydrates containing no cholesterol, mushrooms, tomatoes, squash, cabbage. And we know that a simply healthy superfoods diet of brown rice, and by the way, my number one choice is the number one protein on the planet, bar none, and you're going to think eggs, cheese, and meat based on rat studies done by Osborne and Mendel in 1914. I'm going to tell you yams and sweet potatoes. And based on the Okinawans, who are the longest lived people in the world, they arguably absorb their protein absorption better from yams and sweet potatoes. And they, contrary to popular belief, they only eat fish twice a month. They eat a lot of fruit, a lot of whole foods and vegetables, and a lot of purple sweet potatoes. Stay Young, one of my books about joint health, and Simply Healthy, my new cookbook, which is gluten-free, dairy-free, soy-free, oil-free, and meat-free. And you say, what's left? Tasty Asian recipes, Greek, Italian, Mexican recipes. We've adapted over 300 wonderful recipes. We have some books at the back for $20. You should try it out. Simply Healthy. Dr. Kempner at Duke University knew that diabetics did not have diabetes due to an insulin lack. In fact, they produced all the insulin they needed. And yet this has been discovered over and over again that it is not sugar that causes diabetes. And I'm going to repeat myself. It is not sugar that causes diabetes. It has truly been conclusively proven in the medical literature without exception. Excess triglycerides associated with oil and fats from olive oil, corn oil, safflower oil, butter, cheese, and meat is the number one cause of diabetes worldwide. Nathan Pritikin demonstrated this on 4,350 patients. It was very clear in 30 days the diabetes reversed, as did Dr. Kempner in the early 1950s as he reversed kidney disorders, diabetes, and look at before after pictures, losing over 150 pounds within 1 year on a high brown rice fruit diet. And by the way, by the time they got so skinny, they were concerned that they were going to continue to lose weight. So they had to add in an additional amount of calories without protein because these people originally had kidney damage. And it had to be high calorie without protein. Can anyone in the audience tell me what food item or category they added to their diet to sustain their weight so they didn't continue to lose weight? And it's what we would call an empty calorie food. What was that that did not alter their diabetes? They maintained good health and perfect blood sugar levels. Anyone know the answer to that? That's right, they added sugar, 1 pound of sugar a day to maintain their weight, and they still did not become diabetic. It's not sugar that causes diabetes, and not that I'm a fan of sugar, I think anything processed, but all of you think that olive oil and corn oil and safflower oil are so good for you. We'll talk about that at another time. Here's where I broke the world record with 45-pound dumbbells lifting nonstop. In this case, it was with 30-pound dumbbells, 50,500 pounds. So this is my upper body routine that I do barefoot on ice towels to keep the heat drying off my body as I lifted 50,500 pounds in 1 hour. I can still do this at the age of nearly 60. And this was done at the age of 52, breaking the world record. In April 2011, I looked at the curl record in the Guinness book, and it showed Stuart Burrell had done 550 curls in 1 hour with 50 pounds. How many here can do more than 100 curls with 50 pounds? 30 minutes in, I had done 600 curls. Within an hour, I had done 1,038 curls. I broke the Guinness world record. I don't know about you, but training time is a challenge to figure out when do you fit in your training on a daily basis. And more importantly, let's say you're sports specific and you're well trained in certain muscle groups, but you and I know that injuries occur due to imbalances. So when I'm at my computer, and how many here are at your computer at least an hour a day or more? That is the perfect time to do a full body exercise program. What do I mean by that? Are you going to twitch your Kegels? No. I'm going to hook you up to a neuromuscular stimulator and put 400 volts going through your body at low amperage, and you will do the equivalent of 500 sit-ups, 1,000 squats, and 1,000 sit-ups and pull-ups in 45 minutes. Every morning I do this while I'm at my computer. One other reason why I can compete against the world's strongest strength endurance athletes and beat them routinely. My hormone levels, as you can see in 2011, my estrogen testosterone ratio, see the testosterone of 174, which is painfully low. My DHEA was low, cortisol was low, and PSA in that range. And by 2013, you can see my testosterone I had brought up to 1,154 from a low of 174. I balance my hormones. I measure them about every 2 months, and I do urine, saliva, and blood tests. This is a picture with me and Jack LaLanne. How many here are a fan of Jack LaLanne? What a great man. Our industry wouldn't be what it is today. And some of the people in the audience actually knew the people behind Jack LaLanne who had sponsored him, and including, this is Bob Del Matique, one of his good friends, by the way, a picture in the middle at age 84. And Colleen on his your right, age 74, she's now age 85, still in that good of shape. And by the way, she's all pure vegan, no animal product. And Colleen, her daughter on the side. Blood doesn't lie. We look at your hormones, your blood, your chemistries. We train and educate and motivate you through the power of the mind, fitness, and sleep and hormones. Hypnotherapy is incredibly successful. Within 6 days, just listening to a 20-minute tape on your phone, download it at my website, write this down, growyoungandslim.com. Growyoungandslim.com. Any idea or plan or purpose may be placed in the mind through repetition of thought. Napoleon Hill. You can achieve 95% success rate with your clients instead of the 90% failure rate in weight loss and adhering to health and fitness programs through a very special program that I created called Laser Focused Concentration. I'm available to help you, to guide you, and to train you. Thank you very much.